Hi, I'm Linda Spurlock. I'm an assistant professor here in the anthropology department. I started out as an archaeologist, and I've always been interested in making up what happened based on clues. With archaeology, it's stains in the ground or pieces of broken pottery or cast-off flint flakes from tool manufacture, and we're able to figure out so many things from those little hints. So I did archaeology for many years and slowly gravitated more and more to bones, working on prehistoric cemeteries and analyzing the human skeletons. Lovejoy shows me this, the summer of 2002, and says, Linda, I want you to do the pelvis reconstruction. So I did several versions of what I thought this looked like before it broke, including all the ones you see here. And there's little things that we changed over and over again. This is one of the very earliest ones. I had a good experience while I was a graduate student where I was invited to Puerto Rico to analyze the bones from a prehistoric cemetery that was before the time of Columbus. And as I held these ancient skulls in my hand, I was amazed at how much I could tell about the way the person looked. The bones had very rugged markings where the muscles attached, and I could tell by the bridge of the nose this individual had had a very bent kind of hook nose and wide set eyes, and I thought, I would love to put a face on this. I tried my hand at putting faces on skulls, and I was quite successful at it. My artwork looked like the person that used to be alive, as seen on perhaps their driver's license. So that's a sidelight of what I do, is this forensic art. I also do scientific illustrations, and I help reconstruct fossils based on pieces, parts found by paleontologists.